partnership with the County of Peterborough and some support funding from the Federation of Canadian Municipalities Partners for Climate Change Protection Program. And really, I would like shorter names. Shorter we were able to identify our target for reductions, and that was already identified by Caitlin. And our goal in Trent Lakes is to achieve a 26% reduction by 2031. And we are committed to reducing our corporate impacts on climate change, reducing our greenhouse gas emissions, our use of fossil fuels, and adopted lower energy consumption initiatives. Continuing to improve our environmental performance of existing facilities is really important to us. So, the question, I guess you can say, is what have we in Trent Lakes done so far? We've installed new LED lighting at our administration facility. We have put new thermostats in our facility, our administration building, and that has also allowed for the elimination of electric heaters. Oh, good, here we go. And now we've also balanced our heating system. And this whole system slides are available to Caitlin, and I'm sure we'll be posting them, I believe. Mm-hmm. We recocked our windows. We removed an old fridge. We had two. We took the old one. We said, we don't need it. Get rid of it. We have a coffee maker that constantly kept the water hot. We have two people that drink coffee. We now have a Keurig. If they want coffee, they go make it one at a time. We buy appliances. We buy new Energy Star appliances. And we also did streetlight replacements through the LAS. So, one of the things we also did was we put a new metal roof on our municipal building. This is for cost savings and energy efficiency. It's a light color, and we've got an amazing number of compliments as to how it looks. It outperforms other roofing, what's supposed to. It has longer longevity than asphalt roofing. I don't know if anybody's noticed, but I've yet to find an asphalt shingle that lasts the 25 years that they say it's supposed to. So metal roofing definitely has a longer life. And it does contain a certain portion of recycled steel. At our public works, again, new outdoor LED lighting. And that has been, what an amazing difference how bright that is compared to the old yellow tone lighting. New LED lighting at our transfer stations. They have completed numerous energy improvements at our two water treatment plants. They've done energy audits. There is well pump replacements, high lift pump replacements. They've done some water loss monitoring and initiatives, all which are leading to the reduction in our energy footprint. And they say that it's going to be probably a 10 to 20% reduction just at those two small water treatment plants alone. So that's probably less than 400 houses, but every little bit counts. For our medical centers, new energy efficient air conditioners, LED lighting, ductwork, eaf trough improvements, and a new heat exchanger. Parks and recreation. This is sort of a new area for us. We've just branched out into. We're putting new HVAC furnaces at our Galway and Cavendish community centers, new water heaters, electrical upgrades, energy efficient doors and windows are going into our library this year. In 2018, we're installing, our community centers are really going to love this, internet monitored heat and cooling systems. So we will be in control of the temperature at our facilities so that we don't have any more that all of a sudden it's 200 degrees in there and then it's down to minus 10. So we will be monitoring the energy usage at the facilities. I don't know if they'll like it, but it's going to certainly result in some cost savings. Our fire department, and if you have not toured this building, please come see it. It's amazing. We're really, really proud of it. It's to, again, LEEDS, which is Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. We take all their ideas into consideration. Achieving LEEDS standard is extremely expensive, so we're really, it's just as close as we can get with that certification, but we do take all those possibilities into consideration when we're building new facilities. And it's amazing, you walk in there, you're in the middle of the daytime, and you don't even need a light on. It's so bright in there, so you don't, you know, so there's a lot of reduced energy, and the costs for the overall facility are are so low, it's amazing. Now, overall, all our facilities, we now have regular service schedules for all these buildings, which was something we didn't have before, so that we can ensure that our furnaces and air conditioners are the way they should. And we, this is also tied into our asset management, so we can plan ahead, thinking for the future, knowing that that furnace is only going to last 2 more years, so that we can budget and plan and make sure that we get the most energy efficient and appropriate one that we can. Land use planning. We have a community improvement plan for our small little hamlet of Buckhorn. If you're not familiar with Trent Lakes, it's about the only urbanish century. Beautiful little hamlet, but we're working really, really hard to improve it and enhance it. It's on the Trent Center, and it's really an amazing little spot. This year, we're moving forward with a streetscape and green space design plan, and I am never allowed to pick the name of a project again, because that is the most terrible tongue twister that I've ever invented. It's awful. But that one is being ushered back. Tender is going out, I think, this week. Cultural and natural assets. In Buckhorn, to enhance our community improvement plan, we did purchase a 1.4-acre piece of property right on the Trent Severn. We are really, really proud of this purchase and the way that it is, our contractors working on it. It's turned what was an abandoned, icky-looking piece of property into something that's like, wow. Every time I go by there and see what they've done, it's just amazing. It's beautiful. It's going to be natural green space. We've also been working on some naturalized trail development. We're really trying to encourage people to get out, see the area, but without having to do it. So what would you call it? Passive use, non-motorized use of these assets that we have in our community. Waste management. We have been the leaders in the county of Peterborough. We're on Trent Lakes. With respect to waste management, late last year, we decided to go to a clear bag system. What our clear bag system means is now that we're really, really stringent as to what you can put in your garbage now. This has resulted in amazing savings in waste, and I'll just actually put this part to the slide. Our total amount of garbage has been reduced by 34%, which amounts to 434 metric tons. And if that doesn't mean anything to you, you know those great big huge bins? That's 90 less of those 40 cubic yard bins. And we're not done 2017. So, and I know that other municipalities, such as Zero Dumber, are now copying us. But I think it's wonderful. This is something that we're really, really proud of, because it took a lot of educating and teaching our residents, and we're still working on that, but we're getting there. But this was something that was really win-win, and it's amazing. People now come to us and say, wow, I didn't realize how easy it was to reduce the waste that I was creating. And it's been phenomenal. It's really surprising. And I said, we're really proud of it. I can't wait to see what 2018 brings. So, I love this.